Hello everyone, in this video I am showing you your next assignment given by your science teacher. Now, your next assignment is synthetic fibers and plastics. Have you observed these types of threads, fibers and some other types of plastics? Now, first, we have to think about the fibers. What are the natural fibers so that we can understand what are the synthetic fibers? Then, natural fibers is a fiber of thin thread of natural or artificial substance, especially one that is used to make cloth or rope. Fibers can be classified into two main categories, natural and synthetic. Natural fibers are obtained from natural sources such as animals and plants, like hair fibers from the rabbits and goats. We have got these fibers. Cotton fibers from the plants, as you know about the cotton plant, as Pakistan is rich in cotton production. Wool from the sheep. Pakistan is also rich in sheep wool production. Silk from the silkworm. And Punjab areas, there are silkworm industries. Next is linen from the flax plant. Maybe you have observed these plants, but go to some other videos, you will get the how the linen is produced from the flax plant. Now, the natural fiber is produced by two ways, either by the plant fibers or by the animal fibers. Now, first we discuss about the plant fibers. Cotton is produced in the cotton plant, and cotton fiber is obtained from the cotton plant. It is one of the traditional fibers used in the textile industries, one of the most common cotton fiber. Okay, next, linen. Linen fiber is obtained from the flax plant. The properties of linen fabric are very much similar to the cotton fabric. And last is jute. It is obtained from the jute plant. On account of its high strength, it is perfect for use in packaging materials. Next is animal fibers. It is produced, one of the most important thing of animal fiber is silk. It is obtained from the silkworm. The most popular kind of silk is obtained from the mulberry silkworm. Next is wool. It is commonly obtained from the sheep. Wool fabric is soft to the touch and provides warmth to the weather, due to which it is preferred choice for the winter apparel. Like this, removal of the sheep wool. And do you know, in 2 days a silkworm spins thread that is about 1000 to 3000 feet long. Is it interesting? Now, some other animal fibers are yak fiber. The yak is an animal that is largely found in the Himalayas in the India and Tibet. The hair of yak is very useful in the production of warm cloths, mats and socks. Next, after some understanding of the natural fibers, how they are produced, what are the sources they are extract, we are moving towards the what are the synthetic fiber. The fibers made by human beings are called synthetic fibers. A synthetic fiber is a type of chain of small units joined together. Each small unit is actually a chemical substance. Many such small units combine to form a large unit that is called a polymer. All this process you will also study in 9th, first year and second year classes chemistry. Okay, then we will go for further. What is polymer? Combination of small units and formation of a big unit. This is called polymer. These are the synthetic fibers like brushes and some other cloth. Now, I am giving you an activity. Take an iron stand with a clamp. If you have an iron stand, and otherwise you will take some other things to hang. Take a cotton thread of about 60 cm length. Tie it to the clamp so that it hangs freely from it. At the free end, suspended a pan so that weights can be placed in it. Add weights one by one till the thread breaks. Note down the total weight required to break the thread. This weight indicates the strength of the fiber. I am repeating. Tie a cotton thread with some resource available in your homes, and if you are an iron stand, then you will use it. Then tie the cotton thread of about 60 cm length, and at the other end, free end of the thread, tie a simple pan, simple plate and some other things which you have available in your house. Then add weight one by one, 100 gram or 200 gram or whatever weight, or some sort of rice, some sort of beans and other things, in order to get the weight at which thread will break. Now, note the total weight required, or maybe the quantity of rice or quantity of some beans required to break the thread. This weight or quantity indicates the strength of the fiber. Repeat this same activity with the thread of wool, polyester, silk and nylon. Now, tabulate the data as shown in the next table. Arrange the threads in order to their increasing strength. According to their increasing strength. Now, one of the most important precautions. Note that all the threads should be of the same length and almost of the same thickness. मतलब ये नहीं कि आपने एक thread लिया बहुत thick और एक बहुत लिया बहुत thin size का, okay? Then make this type of table: cotton, wool, silk, nylon, polyester, whatever you have available threads, okay? Then you must note down what type of thread you have and what is its identification with the help of your parents or your elder brothers. Now, total weight required to break the thread you will be note down, and you will get what are the properties of these types of synthetic or natural fibers. Repeat the same activity with the threads of wool, polyester, silk and nylon. Tabulate the data as shown in the table. Arrange the threads in order of their increasing strength. Okay. Now, after completing this activity, you will get the information about the strength of the fibers. Now, when you perform second activity, you will get some other information about the fibers. Take two cloth pieces of the same size, roughly about a half a meter square. Means it will be same size, means I am suggesting you the half a meter square, means approximately 1.5 feet square, 1.5 feet length and 1.5 feet breadth. Okay. And if you have not such size available, then you will take equal size, 10 cm by 10 cm or 20 cm by 20 cm, whatever you have available, piece of cloth, two pieces of cloth of different fibers. One of these should be from the natural fiber, means one piece of cloth is of the natural fiber, and other could be a synthetic fiber. And then how will you identify which cloth is a natural fiber and which cloth is synthetic fiber? Then you can take the help of your parents in selecting these pieces. Now, soak these pieces in different mugs, glasses, and whatever container you have available. Okay? In each containing the same amount of water. Means you have take two bottles or two glasses and fill it with the same quantity of water, and then dip both cloths in each one. Okay, now what thinking you will get from this activity about the fiber? Now first you have to observe and answer the questions. First, I am thinking, do the synthetic fiber soaks less water or more water than the natural fabrics? Or you will reverse this question. Do the natural fabric soak means absorb, okay, less or more water than the synthetic fiber? Okay, think it, and after the observation you will give the answer to you in your videos of clip, video clip. Now, do they take less or more time to dry? You have observed that, let's suppose I am giving you an example, synthetic fiber absorb more water than the natural fiber, then you will take out both cloths and hang them in open air and note your time. Do they, which fabric take more time to dry and which fabric take less time to dry? Here one question is also generated, means if synthetic fiber absorbs or soaks more water, then it will take more time to dry. Is it right or not? And if natural fabric absorbs more water, then it will take more time to dry. Think it and give the answer. Now, third question. What does this activity tell you about the characteristics of the synthetic fabric? This is one of the most important questions. You have to think why you perform this activity and what information you get from this activity about the synthetic fiber. Okay? Now, after performing two activities, you will get some information about the natural and synthetic fibers. Next. In this activity, when you perform your activity number two, you have also observed and answered some other things. Take the pieces out of the container after 5 minutes and spread them in the sun for a few minutes. Compare the volume of water remaining in each container. I am repeating, compare the volume of water remaining in each container. Okay, now after performing these activities, you will get a better understanding, knowledge, thinking about the synthetic fibers and the natural fiber and difference between synthetic and natural fibers. Now let's move out. There are some types of synthetic fibers. What are the types? Like this, this, and this. There are four types of synthetic fiber. Number one is rayon. Rayon is normally called as artificial silk. It is behave, look like, and majority properties are similar to the silk. So it is called artificial silk. Number two is nylon. We are using some ropes of the nylon. Number third is polyester. And number four is acrylic fibers. Now, in next step, we will go for one by one each one and discuss their properties and uses. Now, first one is rayon or artificial silk. Rayon was the first man-made fiber from a natural-based element. Means the material used for making of the rayon are natural elements or natural compounds. Rayon is prepared from the cellulose. Rayon has silk-like appearance, hence it is known as artificial silk. Rayon is mixed with cotton to make bed sheets or mixed with wool to make carpets. You will observe these things like in your houses or homes, bed sheets and carpets. Okay, now like these and like carpets. Next, what are the properties of rayon? Properties of rayon: it is easily dyed and woven into cloth, drops well, good absorbent of the sweat, lustrous in appearance. Now, these are the four basic properties of the rayon. Means it is easily dyed, आप इसको आराम से रंग दे सकते हैं और इनको क्लॉथ के अंदर कन्वर्ट कर सकते हैं. ड्रैप्स वेल, इसके अंदर कोई चेंजेस ला सकते हैं आराम से. गुड एब्जॉर्बेंट ऑफ फ्लूइड, अगर आपने इसको वियर किया हुआ है या कोई और चीज़ की तो ये जो बहुत तेजी से पर्सन है एब्जॉर्ब कर लेता है. लस्टर्स इन अपीयरेंस, मतलब बहुत चमकता हुआ शाइनी स्टाइल का हमें मिलता है तो हमें बहुत अच्छी इसकी अपीयरेंस नजर आती है. ठीक है, नाउ व्हाट आर द यूजेस? मिक्स्ड विद ग्लास फाइबर फॉर मेकिंग द हेलमेट. Rayon is using to make helmets, used to make jackets and track suits, used to make surgical dresses, surgical masks, surgical gloves. Upholstery for luxury cars and office and home furnishing. लग्जरी कार्स के अंदर कारपेटिंग वगैरह, उनकी कवर्स, गर्दन कवर वगैरह, उन तमाम चीज़ों में यूज होता है. ठीक है, री इन्फोर्सिंग नायलॉन टायर्स. नायलॉन टायर्स भी आने लग गए, उनके अंदर भी यूज होता है. कर्टेंस, बिकॉज इट ड्रैप्स वेल. कर्टेंस के अंदर भी यूज होता है, जितने भी आपके डिफरेंट वेराइटी के पर्दे वगैरह आ रहे हैं उन सब के अंदर यूज होता है. ड्रेस मटेरियल, बिकॉज इट इज सॉफ्ट, सिल्की एंड मॉइस्चर एब्जॉर्बेंट. तो इस वजह से तमाम डस्ट आपके मटेरियल्स में ये बहुत यूज होता है. ठीक है, नाउ नंबर टू इज नायलॉन. नायलॉन वॉज फर्स्ट डिवेलप्ड इन अमेरिकन साइंटिस्ट वैलेस एच कार्थर फॉर MS डुपेंट, डी न्यूमरस एंड कंपनी American in 1935. It is strongest synthetic plastic material which can be molded to any shape. This is one of the most important properties. One is the strongest synthetic plastic material, one of the, and it can easily mold it to any shape. People believe that nylon has many names since it is produced, its products were simultaneously launched in New York and in London. These are the nylons. Okay, now properties of nylons. One of the main most important property is toughest elastic material. Next is one of the toughest elastic material. Okay, so it is used for the nylon ropes, or used in hiking, or whatever, bahut easily use hoti hai. High tensile strength, bahut powerful hai. स्लाइटली वाटर एब्जॉर्बेंट, ड्राइज क्विकली, यानी कि अगर आप उसको कहीं यूज कर रहे हैं तो हल्का सा पानी एब्जॉर्ब करेगा, और जितना भी सा पानी एब्जॉर्ब किया उसको ड्राई करने में कम से कम वक्त लगाएगा। कैन बी मोल्डेड इनटू फाइबर्स, शीट्स, रॉड, ट्यूब्स एंड कोटिंग, इन तमाम चीजों में आप उसको कन्वर्ट कर सकते हैं आराम से हल्का सा गर्म करके। रेजिस्टेंट टू ऑयल, ऑयल, ग्रीस, मॉथ, फंगस एंड अदर पेस्ट से ये रेजिस्टेंट है, यानी ये जो कॉटन वगैरह होती है उनमें पेस्ट या फंगस वगैरह लग जाती है चीज़ें ना, कीड़े मकोड़े जैसे खराब हो जाती है फंगस लग कर ना कॉटन रोप्स वगैरह, लेकिन नायलॉन रोप्स इन तमाम चीज़ों से फ्री है। ऑयल उसको खराब नहीं करता, ग्रीस उसको खराब नहीं करता, मॉथ्स, फंगस, पेस्ट अगर चीज़ कोई उसको डैमेज नहीं करता। कैन बी मेड इन टू पैलेट्स और पाउडर्ड, पाउडर फॉर्म में नायलॉन मिलता है और पैलेट फॉर्म में मिलता है, और उसको फिर हल्के से प्रोसेस करके इसको कन्वर्ट करते हैं हम लोग डिफरेंट टाइप के प्रोडक्ट्स के अंदर, लाइक फाइबर्स, शीट्स, रॉड्स, ट्यूब्स एंड कोटिंग्स। इज लस्ट्रस एंड इजी टू वॉश, इसको धोना बहुत आसान है, लस्ट्रस है ठीक है, एंड इट्स अ कंप्लीट साइकिल। नाउ नेक्स्ट इज द यूजेस ऑफ नायलॉन। यूजेस ऑफ नायलॉन आर स्ट्रेचेबल वियर्स, जो भी आपको स्ट्रैप्स वगैरह मिलते हैं जो बैग के जो स्ट्रैप्स वगैरह होते हैं वो सारे जो होते हैं बैग बैग जैसे आप लोग हैंग करते हैं शोल्डर्स पे, वो तमाम स्ट्रैप्स वगैरह स्ट्रेचेबल स्ट्रैप्स वगैरह में यूज होता है। सीट बेल्ट में यूज होता है, अप होल्स्ट्री में यूज होता है, जो होते हैं ना उसके जाते हैं वेपन्स के होल्स्टर वगैरह उनमें, रोप्स में, रील थ्रेड्स में, थ्रेड स्लीपिंग बैग्स बने होते हैं, स्विमिंग वेयर्स जितने भी स्विमिंग वेयर्स हैं वो सारे नायलॉन के होते हैं, रेन कोट्स, ट्रैक सूट्स, फिशिंग नेट्स एंड फिशिंग लाइन्स, मेकिंग सारी ठीक है, ये तमाम चीज़ों में नायलॉन यूज होता है ठीक है। नाउ नेक्स्ट इज सम अदर यूजेस ऑफ द नायलॉन। नायलॉन इज यूज फॉर फाइन सारी, साड़ी वगैरह में यूज होता है, थ्रेड, रील थ्रेड, रोप, फिशिंग लाइन्स, फिशिंग नेट्स, कार्पेट्स, रेन कोट, स्विमवेयर, पैराशूट एंड अम्ब्रेला, ये तमाम चीजें जो है वो नायलॉन से बनाई गई हैं ठीक है। नाउ नेक्स्ट इज पॉलिएस्टर। अल्कोहल एंड ऑर्गेनिक एसिड्स रिएक्ट टुगेदर टू मेक अ कंपाउंड कॉल्ड द ईस्टर, विच आर द पॉलीमर्स एंड दीज आर देयरफॉर कॉल्ड द पॉलिएस्टर, दीज आर द पॉलिएस्टर एग्जाम्पल। Now, properties of the polyester. There are some properties, basic properties of polyester. Detailed properties of polyester you will be studied in higher classes. These are resistance to pests and chemicals. One of the basic and important quality of the polyester is it is resistance to the chemicals. It dries quickly, easy to wash, does not shrink or stretches. Cotton things, cotton ropes, cotton cloths are shrink or stretches while washing, but it will not stretch or shrink and easy to wash. Forms a permanent crease if heated and pressed. अगर आपने इसमें permanent crease produce कर देगा जब आपने heat करने पर उसको press कर दिया तो. Tough, lightweight and elastic. These are simple things you can better understand. Now. Use of the polyester. It will use making magnetic audio and video cassettes and floppy disk. In tamam cheezon ki jo casing wagaira hoti hai wo sari polyester se banti hai. Highly suitable for shirting, suiting, sarees and diapers. Diapers, sarees, suits aur shirt wagaira ke andar ye polyester zyada use hota hai. Mixing mein ठीक है, इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि पॉलिस्टर प्योर पॉलिस्टर ये सारी चीजें पड़ी हैं। मिक्स्ड विद फाइबर ग्लास फॉर मोल्डिंग इट इनटू हेलमेट्स, प्रोटेक्टिव शीट्स एंड हल्स इन द बोट्स, ठीक है ना। प्रोटेक्टिव शीट्स मींस यानी पॉलिस्टर को मिक्स किया जाता है डिफरेंट मटेरियल के साथ, और ग्लास फाइबर के साथ तो ये बुलेट प्रूफ शीशे वगैरह डिजाइन किए जाते हैं इसी से, ठीक है ना, बुलेट प्रूफ सूट्स, बुलेट प्रूफ ग्लासेस वगैरह डिजाइन किए जाते हैं। नाउ acrylic fibers, Acrylic fibers is commonly known by the different trade names, such as it has different trade names like acrylene, olein, zifan. It is a synthetic wool like fiber with crimps. This and reusing these things. Now, next is the properties of acrylic. The most important property of acrylic is resistant to moths, soft with crimps, resembling it with the wool, is durable, light and washable, strong and stain resistant. It is also available in sheets and it can also be dyed in different colors. Next is uses of acrylic. Acrylic knitting wool is good for baby wears because they are soft, warm and washable. It is used for making artificial fur, blankets, carpets. Artificial fur means polyester fur वगैरह आते हैं ना, उन सब के अंदर ये acrylic होता है. It is transparent type of acrylic is used to cover automobile lights, lenses, surgical tools. Now, after the types of synthetic fiber, they use their properties, we will discuss about the advantages and disadvantages of the synthetic fibers. There are some advantages and disadvantages of the synthetic fibers. Number one is, all the synthetic fibers are strong. Synthetic fibers are strong, so they can take up heavy things easily. Cotton fibers and activity number one, as I discussed earlier, activity number one will give you more information about this point. Okay. Next, retain their original shape. Synthetic fibers retain their original shape, so it's easy to wash and wear. Next is elasticity. They can easily be stretched out. Inki elasticity capacity bahut zyada hoti hai. They are soft. Synthetic fibers are generally soft. They are mostly used in clothing materials. They are available in variety of colors as they are manufactured or as per their requirements. Cost. Cloth made by the synthetic fiber are generally cheaper than those made by the natural fiber. I am giving you one of the simplest examples. You will purchase a bag. A bag made with pure leather. And you are purchasing a bag made with synthetic fiber. Both have a vast range, vast difference of price in them. You will purchase a leather bag, then it will cost you approximately 10,000 to 8,000 rupees. And if you are purchasing the same bag with a synthetic fiber made, then it will cost you 2,000 to 3,000 maybe. Now, next is the disadvantages of the synthetic fiber. Number one, they do not absorb the moisture. Maybe it is an advantage, but in some places it will behave as a disadvantage. Synthetic fibers do not absorb sweat, trapping heat in our body. This is one of the main disadvantages. Then it means when you are wearing synthetic fibers cloth, then you will feel hot. You will feel heating in your body. And thus these cloths are used in winter season. Next, rough feel. Synthetic fibers may give rough feel, making it unsuitable for pajamas and undergarments. Catching fires. It is dangerous to wear these synthetic fibers and move towards the fire, as they catch fire easily. All have you observed these things? then you will take a small piece of synthetic fiber, any one small piece, 1 by 1 centimeter or 2 by 2 centimeter, and place it near to the fire. Then you will see how fast they catch fire. Next, iron problem. As I will discuss in the above problem, catch fire, it is dangerous and need careful attention when you are doing in iron. They cannot be easily ironed as they melt very easily. So when you are ironing these cloths, synthetic fiber cloths, then you have to pay full attention to these things and iron temperature also. Next, after studying about the natural synthetic fibers, types of fibers, their advantages and disadvantages, plastic is one of the most important synthetic fiber. Have you observed these things? Plastic milk and juice bottles, plastic cold drink bottles, plastic chairs, tables in every school and every home nowadays. Play sets like slides and some swing toys are available for the child. New bottles, plastic detergents, buckets, containers, and frisbee like some other things. Nowadays, some cricket utensils are also available in plastic. Cricket, football, and table tennis, and other things. Nowadays, stadium seats, Davo bus seats, and other highway bus seats are also in plastics. Next, then what is plastic? It is also a polymer like the synthetic fiber. All plastic do not have the same type of arrangement. They are different, and 100,000 types of plastic, and each one have different type of arrangements of different units. In some it is a linear, whereas in other it is a cross-linked. What is linear and what is cross-linked, you will be studying in higher classes second year if you will take chemistry subject. Now, plastics are of mainly of the two types. One is the thermoplastic and other is the thermosetting plastic. Nowadays, different types of plastic dinner sets, plastic pipes, plastic bottles and plastic bags. Next, first type is thermoplastics. What are thermoplastics? Some plastic articles can bend easily, while some break when forced to bend. When we add hot water to a plastic bottle, it gets deformed. Have you observed it? Take a plastic water bottle or Coca-Cola or something, cold drink bottle, plastic bottle, and take hot water and pour it in it. Add hot boil water in the plastic bottle. You will observe that it gets deformed. And if you have some problems about this activity, then you will go to some videos and what will happen when we add hot water to the plastic body. Such plastics which get deformed easily on heating and can be bent easily are known as thermoplastics. I am repeating, if plastic can easily deform with the help of some or small amount of heating and it will change its shape or it will bend easily, then this type of plastics are known as thermoplastics, like wires and some other chairs like this examples. Next, the examples of the thermoplastics are plastic table and chairs, plastic food container, have you got fast food containers and biryani containers? These are all thermoplastics. Nowadays, plastic toys are also available which are thermoplastics. Plastic spoon and forks you are using in disposable spoons and plates is also plastic of the thermoplastics. Plastic cups are the thermoplastic available. Plastic daily use items like some other things, scale, sharpener, and some more things. These are all plastic. Nowadays, pen, ink remover are also plastics. Next. Number second type is thermosetting plastic. It means after heat they will be getting set. Some plastic which when molded once, it means when you have heat them and they will mold in some shape once, cannot be softened by heat. Then after that you will be heat them and they will never soft. These are called thermosetting plastic. One of the most common example which you will observe at your homes, plastic dinner sets and plastic plates available at your home. So dinner set plates, so you will pour hot or boil something in your plates, plastic plates, and they will not melted. They are not softened, but they are made of the plastic. They will break down, they will break into pieces, but they will never soft and they will never deform. These are the examples of thermosetting plastics. These type of plastic cups, plates and glasses, these are the plastics. And one of the most important plastic of thermosetting plastics are your electrical utensils like bulb holder, circuit breakers, your circuit board, your switch boards. These are all made of the plastic, but they are thermosetting plastic. You will get one plastic switch and then start it heating. As you heating, it will be hot and hot and more hotter, but it will never melt down and it will never soft. The examples of the thermosetting plastics are thermostat handles. All you have some utensils at your kitchens and they have some plastic over their handles, then these are all thermosetting plastics. Firefighters uniform is coated with the thermoset plastic to make it fire resistant. Some melamine wares like nuts, jacks, some other things which are used in some big toys, cars, they are also thermosetting plastic. And all your electric appliances, electric pins are thermosetting plastics. What are the basic properties of the plastics? First is, they are resistant to corrosion. Means, tamam kisam ke plastic ko zang nahi lagta. To ye hawa se ya paani se reaction nahi karte. Iski wajah se ye bahut der tak istemal karte hain. Aur without any damage. They are resistant to high temperatures like thermosetting plastics. They are best insulator of heat and electricity. They are elastic. Thermoplastic can be recycled. Thermosetting plastic cannot recycle, but thermoplastic can be recycled. Not reactive to chemicals and water. Means if you are filling some cold drink inside a plastic bottle, then they will never ever react with the compound and they will never react with the water. So plastics are much more commonly used because of this one of the most important property. Next is, they are water resistant. They are soft when hot. Plastic is non-reactive, means you know that metals like iron get rusted when left exposed to. We have observed so many things. Exposed to the moisture and air, but plastic do not react with water and air. They are not corroded easily. इनको रंग लगता ही नहीं है और इसलिए ये long term basis पे use होते हैं. Like I will purchase some metal bottle for water and I will purchase some high quality plastic bottle for the water. Then after 1 year, beside of my regular use, my metal bottle will get corroded. And after that, it will be dangerous for me that I will drink water in the corroded bottle or drink milk in the corroded metal bottle. But after 1 year or 2 years, plastic will not damage and it will not react with the water or milk and some other juices which I filled in the, my plastic bottle. That is why they are used to store various kind of material, including many chemicals. We have brought so many chemicals from different companies, from different universities and different shops. They are all provided in plastic bottles because of this property that they will never ever react with some any other chemicals. They are light, strong and durable. Talk to your parents or grandparents about the types of bucket they were used. What type of buckets, what material they are, and what are the properties why they are using these buckets. In the past, what is the material of the bucket? In the past, the bucket used are of the wood. And in rare cases, some of them are used of the metal buckets. What is the material of the bucket or mugs you are using today? What are the advantages of using a plastic container? Since these are the questions which arises in the scientist brains, and they made something like lightweight, strong and durable. Feel like you will hold a wooden bucket or metallic bottle, metallic bucket of approx size 2 by 2 feet, then what is your condition by holding this bucket too long? Then if you are holding a bucket of 2 by 2 feet size and for a day, then which one is more easier to you? Since plastic is very light, strong, durable and can be molded into different shapes and sizes, it is used for various purposes. Plastics are generally cheaper than the metals. The most important thing, all the plastics replace the metals. They are widely used in industry and for household articles. One of the most important thing of the plastic is they are poor conductors, for which both electricity and heat. Some electrical tools have insulated with the plastic, like in the given example. So they will better for us for insulate for the electricity. Plastics are poor conductor of heat and electricity. That is why electrical wires have plastic covering. Handles of the screwdrivers are made of the plastic, as mentioned above. Handles of frying pans and some other cooking utensils are also having handles with the plastics. After these properties and these types of plastic, we will study what is the effect of plastic on our environment. This type of effect, this type of effect. When we go to market, we get usually things wrapped in the plastic or packed in the polythene bags. That is one reason why plastic waste keep getting accumulated in our homes. Ultimately, plastic finds its way in the garbage. Disposable of plastic is a major problem. A material which gets decomposed through natural process, such as the action by the bacteria, is called a biodegradable. A material which is not easily decomposed by the natural process is termed as a non-biodegradable. So, what do you think? Plastic is biodegradable or plastic is non-biodegradable? Think it. Now, it's our duty as our school QBHS gives cotton bags in order to stop the use of plastic bags. So it's our duty to save the environment. Like we use metal balls, metal bottles and some other bottles to reduce the use of plastic. Since plastic takes several years to decompose. It is not environment friendly. It causes environmental pollution. Beside this, the burning process of the plastic in the synthetic material is quite slow, and it does not get completely burned easily. You will get practice by yourself. Take one small plastic bottle and burn it, and you will get your answer. It will reduce in size, but it will never burn out. In the process, it releases lots of poisonous fumes, you will observe it, into the atmosphere, causing air pollution. How can this problem be solved? Think it. Avoid the use of plastic as far as possible. Make use of bags made of cotton or jute. Have you observed jute bags which are using in the big markets and some other things? When you go for shopping, the biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste should be collected separately and disposed of separately. You have to start this practice first from your home. It is better to recycle the plastic waste. Most of the thermoplastic can be recycled. Then start now and let's start to clean the environment. Make a list of items that can be recycled. You will make your items at your home. Means plastic toothbrush, plastic bottle, how many types of things you will recycle or reuse them for more durability. During recycling, certain coloring agents are added. This limits its usage, especially for the storage of the food. Now, these are the plastic reuse processes volunteers. Let's take a promise. What you have to do. Do not throw plastic bag in the water bodies or on the road. Near water bodies, open manholes, you don't have need to throw the plastic bags inside these. Take a cotton carry bag or jute bag while going for the shopping. This is provided by Kamalmani Hashim School for so many people, and so many teachers also uses these cotton carry bags. Even I am also using these bags, and I am refuses the shopkeepers do not give me plastic bags. I will have a cotton bag. Okay. Now, try to minimize the use of plastic material as a use of steel lunch box instead of plastic one. This is one of the most important things. Thank you.